whatever you want to say, you know, and there's certainly low lights on the course of the Patriots run. That goes without saying. All right, but Robert Kraft, as an owner, as an administrator, as a manager, you know, he understands how and when and why it's unbelievably important to take those steps back and trust your people and give them autonomy. Show them your confidence so that they can go out and do what they do to the best of their abilities. And there is continuity, togetherness, fraternity, brotherhood in your ranks, you know, and operating in that capacity, you know, look at what the results can be. All right? And again, it's not just how you win. It's not just that you win and lose. It's how you win and lose. And when those things are in the mix, let me get off my soapbox in a second here. On this little rant. You know, but, you know, it's a tale of two cities. Dallas could have been New England in a much bigger market, and they're not. And it comes from the top. And clear, specific decisions that were not made. Folks, we got a couple more things, and we're going to get to them. As far as the NFL, let me just, you know, again, the Patriots losing. We got three games to go. The playoff races in both conferences. As happens every year, you know, you're going to have a team, particularly in the NFC, like the Cowboys, that really shouldn't be in the playoffs. There's going to be some teams with much but better records, but because they're going to win, you know, they have a weaker division, they're going to get in the dance, and a few teams, we'll get those for you on the screen, are not going to be in the dance. Pittsburgh Steelers, Mike Tomlin, starting off 0-3, now 7-5, could easily be 8-4. They were supposed to win that game against the Browns at home, but went on the road to beat Cleveland with their third-string quarterback. Just tremendous. And Browns, we'll get to them as we go into the playoffs. We're going to keep with football today. NBA, we are gearing up for Christmas Day, frankly. You know, NBA action to the backseat to the NFL and the college action as it should. But we have some storylines that we need to get to. Michigan Wolverines just got absolutely demolished. This has to stop. Never mind the fact that I grew up. What's going on here with this table? The table's out of control. Excuse me, folks. Put my table in order. I'm getting sore. We gotta have organization. I'm, you know, pot calling the kettle black over here. I'm talking to other people. Meanwhile, I'm not organized. It has to end. Harbaugh, Jim, you gotta go. Has to go. Not that you win or lose, how you win or lose, his games are non-competitive. His troops are tuning him out. His message is not being received, and he continues to fail to innovate, to evolve, to remodel, to remake, to redo, however you want to see. The man's stuck in his ways, he's got to go. Alright, obviously, and people are talking crazy. Skip Bayless, who's at the forefront of the Cowboys Nation, needs to be talked off the ledge. was saying that he would like Harbaugh to become the coach, I have no idea. That take is preposterous to me. All right? Clear front runners are Lincoln Riley and Urban Myers. All right? Jim Harbaugh, the man, he catches lightning in a bottle, and then after that, it just fizzles. This is soda pop that you open and just left out, you know, not even in the refrigerator for at least a week or two. And you're expecting it to have that pop, to have that kick, you know, to deliver that, you know, to get your stomach right. No. Grandfather graduated from the University of Michigan. After graduating from Howard University, serving the Korean War. You know, my ties to Michigan, both, you know, Fab Five, that is my childhood. You know? And so, yeah, it's one of the teams I root for. And was hopeful with Harbaugh coming in to kind of balance scales when they have Urban Meyer. Never, when you're right, you're right. When you're wrong. Harbaugh, you're just wrong. And you take some more accountability. Him going to the press conference talking about, I'll answer your questions, not your insult. Okay? What's insulting is your coaching. That's what's insulting. Don't put it off on the... And that's your problem, by the way. You look what Brad Stevens did last year after the Celtics season, which was a debacle in many ways. All right? He took accountability. First and foremost. And now look at what the team did this year. Starts from the top. And I don't want to hear anything about reporters. You know, this, that, and third, or, you know, your moodiness and your attitude, you need to get them going. Great points. I was brought up today on Speak for Yourself. Here's Marcellus Wiley. University of Michigan just built a $160 million facility. They breaking bread. Had a couple 10-win seasons, and, you know, they're better than they were before he got there, but, you know, that's not good enough for University of Michigan. Not even close. All right? This is about beating Ohio State. This is about winning the national championship. This is a great organization. This is a great one of the great teams across the board in college sports.